Students, we are going to see about the storage organizations. Each and every programs are stored in logical address space. If you want to execute that program into memory, we are using to store physical address space. The operating system is used to map the logical address into physical address. Subdivisions of runtime memory: code, static data, stack, free memory, heap. Code and static data, the code and static data are determined at compile time. Stack and keeps data objects allocated at run times. Stacks, for example, activation record. Keeps, for example, malloc. Runtime storages comes into blocks, where bytes is used to store the smallest unit of addressable memory. Runtime storages can be subdivided into different components of an executing programs: generated executable code, static data objects, dynamic data objects, automatic data objects. Generated executable code, static data objects, we are using compile time. Dynamic data objects and automatic data objects, we are using run times. Dynamic data objects, example, keep. Automatic data objects, you are using stack. Activation record: data objects are allocated at run times. Control stack is here runtime stack. Control stack means runtime stack, which is used to keep track of the live procedure activations. It has two type of activations. One is activation begins, second one activation ends. Activation begins means push the information onto the stack. Activation end means pop the information on the stack. The diagram below show the contents of activation records. It has 7 fields: return values, actual parameter, control links, access links, saved machine status, local data, temporaries. Return value, for example, a equal to function call. After that, we are using function definition. Function call is used to call the function definitions. Function definition is used to return the result to function call. Function call, that result is stored in one temporary variable. After that, value a is displayed here. That is called a return value. For it is used by calling procedure to return a value to called procedure. Then actual parameter, for example, function call has the values is passed to the function definition. That is called, that parameters is called actual parameters. After that, we are using to control link. Control links means it is used to point to activation record of the caller. Access link, it is used to refer to called non-local data held in other activation records. Saved machine status of the saved informations in the machines. Local data means it holds the data that is local to the execution of the procedures. Temporaries, it stores the values that arises in the evaluations of an expressions. Storage allocations. Storage allocation, it has three types of allocations: static allocations, stack, then keep. Static storage allocations, if memory is created at compile time, then the memory will be created in static area and only once. Static allocation support the dynamic data structure. That means memory is created only at compile time and deallocated after program's completions. It has two type of drawbacks. One drawback is size and positions of data objects should be known at compile times. Another drawback is restriction of the recursion procedures. Stack storage allocations. In static storage allocation, storage is organized as a stack. For example, stack, we are using activation record. Activation record means it has, when activation begins, the activation record is pushed into the stack. When the activation end, the activation record is popped. Activation record contains the locals, because to refresh storage in each activation records, it has used last in first out. Next, it has support recursive process. Then heap storage allocation. Heap storage allocation is the most flexible allocation schemes. It is used to allocate and deallocate of memory at any time and at any place. keep allocation is used to allocate memory to the variable dynamically. For example, for heap storages, keep storages here used factorial. Factorial it has n less than equal to 1. Just I have to apply n equal to 1, it will be written 1. And just I have to apply n equal to 6, I will got output as 720. It will be executed dynamically. Allocate the memory. First value n equal to 1, it will be written 1. N equal to 2, it will be written 2. N equal to 3, it will be written 6. N equal to 4, it will be 24. N equal to 4, value is 120. N equal to 6, it will be written 720. It will be executed recursively. That is the example for heap storages. Thank you.